Dámy a pánové, dovolte mi, abych vás přivítal na zahájení výstavy Made in NL, NL Architects. Mám jeho povinnosti přivítat mezi námi velvyslance Nizozemského království v Praze, pana Jana Hennemana. Dále bych chtěl přivítat Karla Klaseho a jeho kolegu Gen Yamamoto z NL Architects. I Adama Gebriana, který nám řekne pak pár slov k NL Architects. A nyní teda předám slovo panu velvyslanci.
Děkuji moc krát. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. I had a beautiful speech prepared for tonight. And I will change the speech a little bit. First, because it is so crowded, and I'm very happy that it is so crowded. But I can't find my wife anymore. Ah, please, come a little bit to the center. With the Jaarzaal Fraker Gallery, we have a long time cooperation with the Netherlands. We did it with architects individually or together with other countries like in the framework of UNIC. Creative industries in the Netherlands, architecture, design and fashion are a priority for our government because we believe that it is a sector where culture and economy meet, where we have internationally a strong and appreciated position, and where we meet people like today from NL Architects. Lydia and I met the gentleman already earlier this year in June, and there again it was a crowd like today, and I don't know, you must have somewhere magnets that you're attracting so many people, but when you look around at these panels, and I've been told that it is the first time that you show these panels to a public, so you have a premiere in Prague, in your beautiful gallery. When you look at these panels, you see how architecture and the vision of architects translate into concrete projects, sometimes not, and sometimes it just gives an impetus for other people to think further and further. And I think that what you see here is an example, or sorry, a lot of examples of such vision which makes architecture and Dutch architecture extremely dynamic. And that's why we are very proud to have the gallery and you here in Prague. I would like to draw your attention to two panels in the exhibition. One solution of a city-like problem is over there, the second panel, you see one of our retail stores up at hand under a flyover of a main road in the vicinity of Amsterdam. I think it is brilliant, and you said me in your lecture in June that it was the best Albert Heijn shop in the Netherlands. And Albert Heijn, of course, you know, it is Albert here in the chat. And the last or the first picture in this range is a picture of Ostrava, where you designed a part of the former industrial area. So you did already some very important work here. I think it is thought-provoking what you are doing, and I hope that even more people than tonight will enjoy your gallery in this exhibition. I thank you very much for your wonderful cooperation. And congratulations.
Thank you very much for the presentation from the Embassy. And the next speech, Adam.
Thank you. Good evening. I've been asked by Kamil to say a couple of phrases about NL Architects, so I've been extremely flattered to the architects. I firstly met their work at the end of 90s, I remember it exactly because it was two works, and you can see it both in this exhibition. One is Voss 8, I think, the black mysterious object, which is in here. And the other one is called Karstadt, like the parking house. It's actually the shopping store with the parking on the rooftop, and it's been designed for the exact historical center for Amsterdam. And both of the objects, when I seen for the first time, I was like, what is it? You know, this can't be possible. I mean, it's such a radical and beautiful and mysterious. And there's a famous American theoretician, Jeff Gibbs, who said that there are only two options how to come up with something new. And the first one is evolution, which is extremely painful and it takes long. And the other one is the change of context. So you take something which was designed for something else and bring it somewhere else, and suddenly you get something new. And I think actually NL architects combine both of these things, as you can see in all of these projects, that they are evolutionary and yet they're very radically sometimes changing the context. So that was my first encounter with their work. And in 2002, together with my wife Marketa, she's somewhere in the middle of the crowd, we went together to Holland and to study there. And after 2 weeks, she kind of I had enough of school, but for her, the school was not enough. So she's been looking for a job, and she said, so who should I work for? And I said, you should start from the top, so you go to work for NL Architects. And so she applied, she's been accepted, and she started to work there. And after a month later, I kind of thought, I would be interested in it too. So I sent my portfolio there, and I never received any answer. So that also shows that they've got a really good taste, I think, because they definitely selected the more talented out of two of us. So that it's not only about it's good, but they're also smart and clever. And the last thing I want to say is that what I really enjoy about their projects is that they are funny. And funny is suspicious in Czech Republic. If it's funny, it's really suspicious. It's if it's good, it must be really serious and really well thought. So if it's funny, don't pay attention. And I think in my mind, their work is funny and clever, which is quite rare to combine those two things. And that's why it's so unique. So I really enjoy watching their work because I really think it's clever and funny. And the last thing, the topic which I'm interested in most is paradox. And I think the majority of their work is paradoxical. So it's always about that you want to solve two things that basically goes against each other. And I think their job, and they are pretty successful in this, is combining those two things together with the success of two. Thank you.
I think I also have to say something, so Mr. Ambassadors, thank you very much for the support. Dan, I'm very happy you asked us, because somehow architects always need a counterpart, or normally you call it a client, someone that's a sparring partner, you like to sort of fight with a little bit, but just to get better. And what we needed was you to ask us to think about how to present our work. I know you're so eloquent and evil, I would say. Adam, normally I would never dare to ask someone to do a speech, but I know you're so eloquent and easy and clever that I dared to ask you 1 week in advance. So thank you very much for your kind words, and I agree.
Budget problems.